हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, जय हिंद, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग। यू हैव ऑलरेडी अटेंडेड टू लेक्चर्स इन कंस्ट्रक्शन। इन बोथ दिस लेक्चर ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 9, अंडरस्टैंड, वी हैव कंप्लीटेड वन टाइप ऑफ construction, and as you know in the start of this chapter I have told you that in this particular chapter we are going to learn only construction of quadrilaterals. That is what we are going to learn in this chapter. Now dear student, as far as construction of quadrilateral is concerned, we have in lecture number 1 and in lecture number 2 have covered type 1 construction. What was that type? Constructing a quadrilateral when 4 sides and 1 diagonal is given. That type of construction we have already done. Understood? Now what we are going to do in our today's lecture number 3, we are going to construct another quadrilateral in which the condition for constructing the quadrilateral is going to change. Understand? So first, before we start, let us just write the title of the chapter, that is chapter number 9, as you all know. Okay, the name of the chapter, as you know, construction, where we are going to construct quadrilaterals only. And today you are already attending in this particular chapter, lecture number 3. Okay, now dear student, as far as lecture number 3 is concerned regarding this particular chapter, type 2 construction means which type of data will be given to you. Type 2 construction, as we and you all know, we are going to continue the topic of construction in the recorded lectures as I got your reviews in our Zoom live meeting, understand, where you have on Saturday, where actually you have given a feedback that this is okay and you are able to understand. So we continue the lectures of construction chapter in the same way. Now, dear student, today we are going to construct a quadrilateral which I can call type 2 construction. Means we are going to construct the quadrilateral under some particular condition. Which is that condition in today's lecture? When you need to understand this, when 3 sides, when 3 sides and 2 diagonals were given, this is the condition. You have to construct a quadrilateral in which 3 sides and 2 diagonals are given. This is the basic title of the construction we are going to perform. Okay, so dear student, as I told you, construction may be of any type, either 4 side 2 diagonal, now 3 sides 2 diagonal. The basic remains in the topic of construction is you need to develop rough sketch of the quadrilateral first. Rough sketch. First you have to construct. That will give you an idea. Okay. So we are writing the question for this, and this is the question. Okay. Write with me. I am giving it construction number 3 because 2 we have done. What is the title? Construct. Write with me. Construct quadrilateral ABCD in which construct quadrilateral ABCD in which AB equals 2, 5.3 centimeter, okay, BC, I'm just continuing here, equal to 6.1 centimeter, CD equal to 4.8 centimeter, comma, AC equal to 7.1 centimeter, and BD equal to 6.2 centimeter. This is the question. Please first note down the question before we continue. It's rough sketch and we'll draw the construction. Construct quadrilateral ABCD in which AB equal to 5.3 centimeter, BC equal to 6.1 centimeter, CD equal to 4.8 centimeter, AC equal to 7.1 centimeter, and BD equal to 6.2 centimeter. Nobody in exam is going to clarify for you that this is a construction of quadrilateral of type 2 when you are given 3 sides and 2 diagonal. Nobody is going to disclose. It is you yourself who is going to judge that which type of construction is this. As usual we do, after reading the question here, the first thing which we are going to do is we will construct a simple rough sketch of the quadrilateral. Okay, I am constructing myself. Just draw the rough sketch. This is rough sketch of the quadrilateral. Okay. I am naming the quadrilateral as ABCD. Now, which measurements are given in this? AB, that is 5.3, BC, that is 6.1, CD, that is 4.8, diagonal AC, you have to be very conscious in this, that is 7.1, and another diagonal BD is also given 6.2. Once, whenever you draw the rough sketch, that rough sketch is going to give you the hints how to construct the quadrilateral. Understand? So whenever you draw the rough sketch, it is going to give you an idea regarding the construction. Okay, see dear student, we can start construction from this. AB has been given 5.3 centimeter. Every time during the whole chapter of construction, once I draw any one construction here, I will give you time to be comfortable and do it with me. Okay? First, dear student, AB, we are targeting this line segment, particularly AB equal to 5.3 centimeter. Okay, let me draw here. I have drawn AB. You have enough comfort because you are utilizing ruler. Okay, so as I told you in start of the chapter, there may be minor variation of your construction and mine a little bit. Okay, first draw AB of 5 centimeter. Okay, this is your first target. First you have to draw line segment AB of 5.3 centimeter. Now see, dear student, I am showing here I have already got two vertices of quadrilateral A and B. Now I am targeting this particular vertex. So for getting vertex C, where should I concentrate? I have to concentrate on two centers. First B, then A. Why? Taking B as center and radius 6.1 centimeter, I will draw an arc. Then, taking A as center and radius of 7.1 centimeter, I will draw another arc. Both the arcs are going to intersect at a particular point, which will give me vertex C. Okay, so dear student, I am just showing you my pair of compass. You already have a pair of compass with you. See, some of the students on that day raised some questions that, sir, how can we understand the use of the compass and how can we write the steps of the construction? At that time I explained you in Zoom meeting already. Understand? I think Tanish Mendapara produced that doubt. Now see, I am keeping center at B, and how much radius you have to take on your ruler? 6.1 centimeter. Any student who are in doubt, please concentrate. Where you keep the, this is your pencil, okay? Where you keep your compass, the sharpened end of the compass, that is called the center, and measurement radius, you know, 6.1. So I have already taken a radius of, this is 5.3, so little more than that, okay, for me only. You just do it by yourself, taking B as the center, okay, and radius 6.1 centimeter. Okay, let me draw one arc here. Okay, so you also draw with me B as center and radius 6.1 centimeter. Draw an arc. You understood this? Taking B as center radius of 6.1 centimeter, you have drawn one arc. Right. Now, as you have to concentrate, one arc you have to take A as the center. And can you guess what could be the radius you will take? 7.1 centimeter, because AC is of 7.1 centimeter. So I will take the radius 7.1. I will place the compass at A and draw another arc. Okay. See, I am showing taking A center and radius of 7.1. Draw another arc and you will get point C. Okay. I am giving you time to just draw this. Okay. Is it clear? First, you have taken B as center and radius 6.51 and have drawn one arc. Now, you must have, for the second arc, taken A as center and radius of 7.1. You must have drawn another arc. Intersection point of both the arc is point C. Let me join this two line segment, which are actually two sides of the quadrilateral. You also join. You will also join one diagonal. Okay. See, dear student, we had two vertices A and B, and now we have already got the third vertex, that is C. First, you accomplish at least up to this, okay? And then you have to start thinking of how to obtain point D. And for that purpose, you have to concentrate on those two line segments where D is common. That means you will concentrate on CD and BD, not on AD, because AD we don't have. So, dear student, now here, CD, you will take center at C and radius of 4.8 centimeter and will draw one arc. Suppose I take the center at C and I will draw the arc here. Okay. You please draw. Taking, can you understand my point, dear student? Taking C as center and radius 4.8, you have to draw an arc. There may be a minor dislocation or disposition of the arc, understand, because you are drawing it exactly with geometric instrument you have. So minor variation is going to take place. Taking C as center, understood, and radius of 4.8 centimeter, we have drawn an arc. Understand? One arc has been drawn, right? Okay. Now, dear student, for drawing the another arc, BD, for this, taking, just concentrate here, taking B as center and radius 7.1, you will draw another arc. First, you take radius of 7.1, okay, and then you will draw another arc, taking B as center to intersect this particular arc. Okay, and the intersection point of both the arc is going to be C7 radius of radius of 6.2, 7.1 for AC, 6.2, understand? And you draw another arc. Both the arc will intersect at point D. Then you will join line segment CD as well as line segment AD also, and then you will obviously join diagonal BD also. And after doing this, you will show all the measurement in construction, but measurement needs to be shown by small writing candidly, okay? And here you do not have to write the scale of centimeter, just you show in this way, that is sufficient for me. 7.1 and this is 4.1, and as I told you, once you draw the construction, just make the all four sides of quadrilateral with little hard line, okay? You have to draw little hard line to visualize the quadrilateral, okay? So dear students, this way the construction of quadrilateral is over, which involves construction of quadrilateral having how much side? Three sides and two diagonal has been given. Any type of construction you are going to feel comfort when you know the rough sketch. Okay, rough sketch is actually giving you idea how to construct any quadrilateral. This is type 2. Understood? Right? Draw the rough sketch and accordingly just draw the construction. Right? Now, dear student, after drawing this, just have a review and then we will write the steps of construction. Can we take the review? How we have done? First, draw line segment AB of 5.3 cm. Taking B as center and radius 6.1, draw an arc. Taking A as center and radius 7.1 centimeter, draw another arc to obtain the point of intersection point C. Then, keeping center at C and radius of 4.8, draw another arc. Taking B as center and radius 6.2, draw another arc. Both are going to intersect at point D, and then you just draw the quadrilateral, okay? So, the construction of quadrilateral is over, and now we will engage ourselves in writing the steps of construction, okay? Steps of construction. Let us first write the title, steps of construction, okay? Steps of construction. First step, what is that? We have drawn line segment AB of how much length? 5.3 centimeter. So first step, draw line segment meant AB of length, you do not need to write, you just write the magnitude only, 5.3 centimeter. Just write the measurement only. Draw line segment AB of 5.3 centimeter. Then the next step. What can be the next step? You have taken B as center and radius of 6.1 centimeter and drawn an arc. So you know how to write this step. I am writing it for you. Draw an arc of a circle. I have already explained you why this is written. Arc of circle taking B as a center and radius, B as center and radius 6.1 centimeter. Then what is the third step? We have taken, for this we have taken A as center, and by taking radius 7.1 centimeter we have drawn an arc. So how will you write? Again the same word formation to be taken. Draw an arc of a circle taking, write with me, A as a center and radius 7.1 centimeter. Both arcs intersect at point C. First you write all these three steps. Okay, first you write these steps. We have written three steps of construction. Okay. For obtaining the vertex C, A and B vertex we have already obtained at the start. Then one arc of a circle is drawn from point B and one is drawn from point A. To realize this particular construction and getting point C. Fourth step. Can you guess? We have taken C as center and radius 4.8 centimeter and arc is drawn. So again, the word formation remains the same. Draw an arc of a circle taking C as center and radius 4.8 centimeter. Draw an arc of circle taking C as center and radius of 4.8 centimeter. You understood? Now for next arc, we have concentrated as a center on point B. As you all know, next arc you have drawn by centering your compass at point B and taking radius of 6.2 centimeter. This radius you have taken to draw the another arc. B will be the center and the radius will be 6.2 centimeter. So how will you write the next point? Draw an arc of a circle taking B as center, and radius 6.2 centimeter. This radius we have to take, taking B as center and radius 6.2 centimeter, and you will write both arcs intersect at point D. Okay, so this way you have already obtained point D, and then the next step I am just continuing here. Okay, what we have done, we have joined all line segment BC, CD, AD, AC, BD. So you will write the step this way. Draw line segment BC, line segment CD, line segment AD, line segment AC, and line segment BD. You understood this? Okay, after you write this step, what will you write in the actually it is not the step, but you have to write, therefore quadrilateral ABCD is required quadrilateral. Okay, this is the way you can complete such type of construction. First, you please verify all steps written by me here, and accordingly you write all steps. First you need to verify all steps, and accordingly you write all the steps here. Right, this is the way we can complete construction when the condition is like this, that construct a quadrilateral in which you are simply given only three sides and two diagonal. And every time I told you, whenever you have to draw any construction, your target should remain the rough sketch first, because once you draw the rough sketch, that is going to give you an idea how can you complete the construction. The rough sketch is very, very essential, right, in drawing any type of construction. Otherwise it may happen that you will not come to know from where to start the construction, and it might confuse you. That's why rough sketch always. You should develop the practice of drawing the rough sketch every time. You understood? Now, you must have written all the steps. We will just have a quick look at all the steps here. Let's have a quick look. Your first step, draw line segment AB of length 5.3 centimeter. Your second step, draw an arc of circle taking B as center and radius 6.1 centimeter. Next step, draw an arc of circle taking A as center and radius 7.1 centimeter. Both the arc intersect at particular point C, understand, which is actually the third vertex of quadrilateral ABCD. Then, taking C, draw an arc of circle taking C as center and radius 4.8 centimeter. Okay. Next step, taking B, draw an arc of circle taking B as a center and radius 6.2 centimeter. Both the arc intersect at particular point D. Understand? So we got construction. At last, you have to write, draw line segment BC, CD, AD, AC and BD. Therefore, you can write quadrilateral ABCD is required quadrilateral. Okay, dear student. So this is what we have done today is type 2 construction. What I have told you in the start of this particular lecture, in exam or in test, when you are asked to draw particular type of construction, nobody is going to assess out and classify for you that this is this type of construction. It is you yourself has to decide which type of construction is this. Understand? Once we draw the rough sketch, we came to know that this is a type of construction of quadrilateral when three sides and two diagonals are given. Okay. Now, dear student, try to understand one very important thing. As far as three lectures are concerned, I have already taught you two types of construction. First, constructing a quadrilateral having four sides and two diagonal. Then we have taken, understand, type 2 in today's lecture, where you have constructed a quadrilateral in which three sides and two diagonals are given. Now, dear student, rest of the type, which we call type 3, are actually involving construction of the quadrilateral when you will be given particular angle. Understand there. So for drawing type 3 type of construction which involves construction of quadrilateral in which you will also be given either 1 angle, 2 angle, 3 angle, etc. So for that purpose we first have to understand how to construct angles without utilization of protractor. Okay, protractor will not be allowed to you in construction. You just have to utilize the pair of compass to complete the construction, but there also angle are involved. So what we are going to do in our next lecture, I am going to teach you thoroughly only to concentrate on to how to draw various types of angles, various measure, various angles of different measures with the help of pair of compass. Okay, so what I am going to do in lecture 3, I am going to, because I want to teach you how to draw various types of angles, so I will definitely utilize my pair of compass for drawing the arc. Okay, so please concentrate. Okay, thank you very much.